69,000 watts of super power. 106.1 KMEL FM, San Francisco, Oakland, San Jose.
Sweetheart, try so hard to get
forever and ever, always. Oh, I don't think so. 6:07 on your morning zoo, Friday morning. It's your final version of this zoo. Where's her now?
Is she late on the last day?
Here she comes. I see her in the security right now. All right, real quick. Anybody want to talk about it real quick? We have like, nah. Just a few seconds here before she gets in. No, I like Renelle. Ma'am, shut up.
This lady will talk about anything.
Be quiet. Talk about that. Who cares? Who cares what the forecast is?
Right.
We're going to be indoors all day. Hey, it's good.
There she is. Oh, yeah.
She's getting stuff. She has bags of stuff in there this morning. Let's take a look at the stuff. Patchy morning, coastal, low clouds and fog, otherwise sunny and warmer. Highs from the mid-60s to the lower 70s. Tonight, patchy late night, low clouds and patchy fog, otherwise fair. Saturday, sunny.
Oh, yeah.
That works out good. That's my actual moving day. That's where I come in and take my stuff away. That's all right. My stuff. Loaded on a big, cold, impersonal truck.
You know, they're going to store it somewhere. I don't feel good about that.
Oh, yeah.
So I worked out a thing where I'd come visit it, you know.
Even, that's neat.
You know, I thought that.
Invitation.
The people at the company thought that was real neat.
Oh, yeah, whatever, sir. Whatever.
Can I see my credenza?
Yeah, right this way, sir.
Oh, yeah.
For now. Are you settled in back there yet? She's not settled in yet. I think she brought some champagne and stuff. That'd be good.
I'm thinking let's pop that puppy now.
Now. Good morning, KMEL.
Hi, Don. You know, I know that you're going to go to Los Angeles to be a star, but I don't see why you have to, because you're just as big star over here as you are going to be over there.
Well, that's very nice. That's very nice of you. But this company wouldn't pay me what I'm worth. They wouldn't come up with the money to pay me what I'm worth.
Yeah, but still, why do you want to go to Los Angeles?
Because they're paying me what I'm worth. They're paying me what I'm worth.
And overcrowded?
Yeah, no, believe me, I hear you. I didn't want to go. There's nothing about Los Angeles that I really like.
It's overcrowded with money.
That's the only good thing about it is they compensate all the evil with green.
John, don't shoot that low.
I'm sorry, ma'am. I'm sorry. I have to look at myself.
Okay, well, I'm really... Well, whatever makes you happy, and I hope you do really good over there also, as you have done up here. And to Brian and Dennis, we're going to miss you also, and you guys are doing
a good job.
Thank
you. Thanks, dear.
And to Renelle, she's in there right now?
No, she's wandering around the hall looking very confused right now.
Really? Okay, well, she's doing a good job, too, and sorry to keep it up. And you guys have a lot of fun, and I hope you get what you want.
Thank you so much.
Bye.
Thank you.
Well, we did. As a matter of fact, we'll have the contracts on display later in the lobby. Thank you. That was very nice. Good morning, KMEL.
How you doing, John?
Good.
I'm at a loss for words, but I was there from the very start. Who is Lyndon and Engelman?
No, that was day one.
Day one. And
Now it's just, who's Engelman?
Teenager. No, it's teenager. Now I'm a married man. Almost.
Is that right?
Yeah.
How old are you?
I'm 25.
So, yeah, you were 19 years old when we started.
Yeah, and I listen to you every day, and, you know, me and my girlfriend listen to you every day, and I'm just going to miss you, and it's not going to be the same without you.
Well, that is so
nice. almost like you're a part of our family because you've been there from every morning.
Well, when you think about it, we almost are. We're with a lot of people for several hours a day. I mean, you're only with your wife probably in the evening for a few hours, and certainly that's far more important than the hours you spend with us. But, yeah, we feel the same way. We've been, you know, we know exactly how you guys think as an audience. We have a kind of a pack mentality, and it's been a lot of fun.
Yeah, well, what radio station are you going to?
The Beat.
The Beat? Well, I hope they appreciate you as much as we do over here. And
can we show them the contract real quick?
Yeah.
Do it. Pull it out.
I guess they do.
No paper.
It seems like they do, sir, but I appreciate that.
Okay, maybe I'll be giving you a call down there because I know I'm going to miss you guys.
No, we're going to give out. We want you to call. Our first day will be April 8th on the air, so we want you to call the request lines down there, and you can help tell Los Angeles that we're not dicks. As they turn in for the first day, listen to these people. And
No, yeah. I'm sure the response will be immediate. They'll love you guys, I'm sure.
Thanks so much. What's your name?
My name's Ed.
Ed, thanks for calling. I really appreciate it, partner.
All right, I'm going to miss you guys.
Take care.
Bye.
Bye-bye. 612 in the zoo. Are you squared away, Rennell? Are you settled in
yeah,
down there?
Yeah.
Was there a problem down there? Was there some equipment problem?
No.
Everything's all right?
Yeah.
You ready to do this?
Yeah.
Now. Now. This is a positive thing, Rennell.
Yes.
This is a positive thing.
I know.
This is really... Hey!
What was that?
What the hell is that? One of our listeners sent the final word in. Have you seen this thing?
No.
Oh, no.
No more.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, no.
I have seen that thing.
All right, let me see. This is sent in from...
Oh, it's the bile box.
Dear John, hey, what's up? Not much here. I don't know if you've gotten my previous letter, but I sent it on Friday. You got a letter. My name's Layla, and the reason why I'm writing you again was because I got you a present. I hope you like it. It's something you could use on the radio. Oh, yeah. Sure.
Yeah. All the time.
Or when you're at home, if someone's getting on your nerves, or if they're being the biggest a-hole. I hope you like it. God bless. P.S. I even put batteries in it for you. Thanks,
good.
Layla. That's very nice. There's four phrases. Only one we can put on the air. Let me see. I got to go over here now. Hang on.
Okay. That's not one we can put on the air.
That's not one we can put on the air. All right. I'll put this over.
Which one are you thinking you can put on?
Is it the next one?
There's no one on there. You
hey, asshole.
Oh, God.
That one.
Oh, man. That's how far we've sunk.
One out of four.
That to us is clean language now.
Yeah, we got to start all over. Yeah, we got to start all over down in Los Angeles. We don't walk on the air going, hey, look at all the answers.
Give us another one, John. One more.
Hang on. Let me go back in the corner. I didn't know that was coming up, and I apologize. Gosh, darn, I'm putting that away right now. How's the Goat Patrol this morning, Rennell?
Oh, more important than that, there's champagne and OJ in the kitchen.
Yes!
Can I say that?
I'm sorry.
I feel like I'm going to be a hostess throughout the day, so that's why I was late. I have, you know, decorations and tablecloths and things to prepare.
Oh, that's beautiful. That's beautiful. What we're thinking about, what we can do while you're doing all that, is we could actually, because you don't know the phrases coming up next to this thing.
Right.
There's four phrases, and we can sit around and gamble, all right? Everybody puts a bucket. All right, what do you think? What do you think?
Okay.
Yeah.
Russian gross out.
In the newsroom, Brian, what's up?
There's only one story today, and we are it. That's it.
In the world of sports, Dennis?
Well, unfortunately, we're not going to get to see Fernando Valenzuela down there when we get down there. They cut him.
They did? Really, really?
They did?
Yeah.
Wow.
He had such a bad outing the other day, and everybody's sad about it, but vaya con Dios, babe.
How bad an outing was it?
It was a
bad. It's horrible.
You know, when I was first down there, they had just hired him. When I first went down there in 79, they had just gotten him. He's had a long career with the Dodgers. It's been a beautiful career.
What a phenomenal.
Well, he was a phenomenal pitcher. And anything else? The Warriors win?
Yeah.
More importantly,
the Lakers.
On your Friday Zoo.
You're here to help me make it important.
106.1 KMEL.
I think I'm going to report you to the FCC now. Continue to do that.
Let's take caller 10 right now for the Zoo Pressure Cooker, 478 KMEL. Oh, I think so. 626, John London, and your Friday morning zoo. You're going to continue doing the zoo pressure cooker, aren't you, right now?
Yes, we are going to continue.
Good. Let me go ahead and start locking this contestant into place. As we greet her now, welcome, please, if you will, to the morning zoo. Insert your name here.
Marion.
Hi, Marion.
All right.
How are you, Marion, this morning?
Oh, I'm okay, I guess.
What do you do for a living, Marion?
Well, I'm retired.
You're retired?
Yeah.
That's a good gig. That's a good gig. That's what we're all working for.
Well, I'm calling from my son, you know.
You're calling from your...
For my son.
For your son.
Yeah, because he wanted to say goodbye to you, and I told him I'll call for him.
Oh, how old is your son?
He's 18.
Well, now, how old are you, Miriam? May I ask? That's a rude question, but I don't care. How old are you?
I'm over 40.
You sound really? You sound like a 15-year-old teenage girl.
Yeah. Oh.
You really do.
Yeah, well, a lot of people say I look very young.
Well, you sound very young, too.
Well, thank you.
How young do you look? You really got to back off from that age. I mean, you've got to shave off at least 15 years.
Well, most of his friends say, is that your mother?
Does your son have a lot of friends?
Pardon?
His age.
Oh, come on. All right, Marion, we have a zoo kid for you. If you can complete the zoo pressure cooker challenge. What's in that zoo kid?
Passes to catch the KMEL premiere of The Marrying Man. She'll have a special edition video cassette of Identity Crisis, yeah, plus two tickets to catch the A's and the Minnesota Twins on Wednesday, April 10th.
I'd like to see that.
All right,
Marion, this seemed appropriate to be our final zoo pressure cooker category. Are you ready?
I'll try.
You'll have 15 seconds to name five moving companies.
Oh, no. God. Hertz.
Who?
Hertz.
Rental cars.
Hertz. Yeah. I'm sorry, they have rent moving.
Okay,
too.
One.
Oh, God. Sunshine Movers.
Sure.
Harrington Brothers.
Harrington Brothers,
yes.
Definite.
Three.
Poor Starving Students.
Yes.
Four.
Oh, God, what's the last one?
Ernie's Movers.
That's me. Moving Company.
Who?
The Worldwide. National.
Somebody give me a yellow page.
There ain't no Acme.
Right,
I got it right here.
What do you got?
Sweetheart.
Listen, you were trying to sell it, too. Oh, yeah, Worldwide. Oh,
World.
World.
Yeah. Yeah.
What is this, the Roadrunner?
Yeah. Access 3 billion.
Okay.
Acme.
A.
Hang on, Marion.
A.
We've got it right here.
Okay, hold on a second. Hold on now. Get ready.
Moving. It should be right up front.
There's no stinking Acme.
Malacca. Everybody knows them so well, they don't even advertise the yellow pages. Yeah. Is that it?
How about Beacons, Allied, Mayflower, Atlas, North American, United National, Franciscan Global Bank?
She loses. Hey, she got Harrington. And that's cool. Everybody laugh at Marion, though. She is our final loser. We're going to get you a zoo kid anyway, Marion, though. You did such a fine job. You came up with some real oddball answers. After listening to them, I'm glad you're out of the workforce, to be quite honest, Marion. You hang up with your zoo kid.
Thank you so much, and good luck to you in L.A.
Thank you. What is your son's name?
Sean.
Sean, take care, partner.
What up, Sean?
If your mom or babe Sean, call us now.
Let's check that Go Patrol. Here's Rennell.
It looks like it's going to be a light commute this morning.
The KMEL Morning Zoo, America's last untamed radio show.
6:35, word of the day coming up. Who do we have to thank for this beautiful, large, magnum-sized bottle of champagne?
We have a loyal zoo listener, Tinka, to thank for that.
Hey, thank you, Tinka. We're going to add a little OJ here to it. We appreciate it very much. Hi, good morning. Good morning. Who's this?
This is John.
John, where are you calling from?
Hayward.
You're my last word of the day contestant, John.
You can't leave, John. You just can't.
You want to bet?
No, you can't.
You go out and high five at one.
Rennell, I love you, but it's just not going to be the same without all these guys. It's not.
You know it's going to be a little different. Hey, let me tell you what.
Bing.
I'm telling you right now, Ryman is in for the 90s, all right? Goodbye, John. I'll miss you.
Well, I may just have to move.
Acme Moving.
Acme Moving. I am Acme Moving, and we're all going with you. Rennell, you're by yourself.
No. Rennell?
Thanks.
Oh, Dave Franklin just walked in with some Amstel.
Okay, Rennell's with Franklin. That's it. Everybody else is going.
What, you got a
Thanks
Coleman
a
cooler?
Champagne.
Hey, there we go. Franklin in his new Jack City hat.
Yeah, that he stole from me yesterday.
$10, anybody come down here and take Franklin's new Jack City hat off his melon. Anybody, come on down and try. Come on down and try. Come on down. Take his hat off. Your word this morning, John, was sent in by Alan Yim, who writes, Dear John, I've been a faithful KMEL listener for the past 2 years. The Morning Zoo program has made coming to work at 6 a.m. much easier for me. Your mindless drivel...
Whoa, wait a minute.
Your mindless drivel keeps me spellbound every weekday morning. If I could pull up roots and follow you to Los Angeles...
Well, what did he want to do? Whose roots does he want to pull up?
Unfortunately, my ties and commitments remain in the Bay Area. However, when I vacation in La La Land this summer, I will be sure to tune you in to your new show. I'll continue to listen to Rennell and the new zoo crew in the future. As you might say, I came for the shtick. I'll stay for the music.
Well, that's a good rhyme. The rhymes are in, baby.
Nice.
I'll take it.
There'll be better rhymes than this on Monday, I'll tell you that for darn sure.
You're telling me?
Sincerely, Alan Yim. And the word this morning is vesicant. Vesicant. Is that a substance which produces blisters? Is it cargo which is transported overseas by Acme Moving? Or is it a small meeting room located at the back of churches?
Say it one more time.
Vesicant.
One.
Number one is exactly right! John, you hang out for your zoo kid, all right?
All right.
106.1 KMEL 651 on the Morning Zoo.
Yeah, okay. Guy goes into the doctor's office. Doc,
Why don't you take a look at my penis? And the doc says, well, jump in the table, put your pants down. Doc studies it for a few minutes and says, I don't, what seems to be the problem? Man says, nothing, I just want you to take a look at my penis.
Oh, Mom, what was that?
God.
Thanks, Cigar Man.
That's cute.
I'll reach out later.
Would you?
Hi, good morning. Who's this?
Hi, this is Brandon's mom.
Oh, Brandon's pushy mother. Come on, get the kid on the phone and get it over with. God. Put up with this pushy broad for about 6
Hold
years.
Hold on. Hold on. He wants to talk to you, John. Here.
Hi, John.
Good morning, Brandon. How are you?
Fine.
You getting ready for school?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Oh, God.
Well, this is a good bit.
Good luck.
His mother's telling him, saying goodbye.
Cue cards.
Goodbye.
Evan luck, bad luck.
Oh, hush.
Booing Brandon off the stage.
Come on, he's a child. Stop it.
That's not me. Hey, Brandon.
People, please.
Brandon. Guy goes into the doctor's office.
No.
Thanks, Brandon. Good luck.
Thank
Bye-bye.
You, sweetie. Take it easy.
It's almost too much.
Quit calling with your cute kids. I don't think they're that damn
John,
cute. We don't
please.
Find them cute. That's one of the reasons I'm leaving. About your kids and your cute little sayings, may I say this? And stop having them. Oh, I see you found some pizza there, Franklin.
A slicer's 9.
John.
Wow. They helped him dig in, Franklin. Don't look. What's the matter? You waiting for, like, silverware? Would you like some silverware?
John, please.
How come I'm going to kick his ass right now?
Stop.
I was going to wait till after lunch, but if I have to right now wait in, I'll do it. Franklin brought by a going. Is this a going away for everybody here? Is this yours? Who brought this?
He brought this in, didn't you?
It's a bomb. Oh, this is from Franklin.
Oh, we're gone, ladies and gentlemen.
To John Dennis Bryan. All right, let's see what Franklin's giving us here for our going away thing.
Oh,
it's beautiful. London Mint Melt-Away Chocolates.
Oh.
Isn't that? London Mint Melt-Away. Yes,
chocolate.
It is. Hey, thanks, Franklin, so much for that. I appreciate it.
Brother?
Yeah, please. I just, you know.
He's hateful.
You know, we're going to go over to the pier in later, and I just hope that somebody will jack with me while Franklin's there. Please, I'd like a wacko to come down and take a swing at me while Franklin's there. Will you please do that?
Uh-huh. Just one.
Just one! Air sales manager. Lee Jameson's in the studio.
Hey, what's up?
Kind of watch it? Kind of standing guard here this morning, Lee?
No, I came to tell you that Rick Dees was absent on the air yesterday in L.A. He must be worried about already. I don't know. He was missing on the air.
Another lawsuit?
Unscheduled vacation.
Hey, I like it. Up here listing stealing material. Huh? What are they doing? I don't understand. That can't possibly work. He's going to die big down there. 6:54 in the morning, Zoo. Let's check some news. Here's Brian.
We'll see what's going on with some sailors that we are...
Hi, good morning. What can I do for you?
You can't leave, John.
I'm leaving.
We're losing Ronnie Lott. We can't lose John London.
Hey, I look forward to seeing Ronnie Lott down there.
Tell me about
it. Absolutely.
Heck, we're working on that now.
You're like a legend out here.
Oh, hardly, sir. Hardly.
You are. You are. I mean, I looked up to you. I had friends who looked up to you. Well, I mean, we talk about you every morning. Hey, you hear what John London said this morning? Now it's like, and no offense to Renell. Renell says funny stuff, too, but...
Sir, what I should do is, you know, just to get this out of your head, I should drive you up to Discovery Bay and have you take a look at my mother, and then you'd realize, no way is this old broad Putin out of legend. No way. Couldn't happen.
Did you hear last night on Love Line? Did you hear what Evan Luck said?
No, what did Evan Luck say?
He was getting ready to give your number out in the air so people can bug you.
Oh, what a good guy.
He was getting ready to do that.
Evan knows, though. Evan knows. I know a little too much about Evan for him to pull that cheap crap. Okay.
Payback's a bitch.
My mom's on the phone. What is it? My mom's on the phone. Hi, good morning.
For a little day.
Shut up. 7:10 in the morning. Let's go back. This is an early one. This was several years back. Do you remember?
This one.
There's a fragrance so unique, so tantalizing, that it cuts through the night air like a sword.
Windbreaker.
The eau de toilette that is carried by a breeze from France, now available in America.
Windbreaker.
Squeeze the atomizer and release the passion. Smell the aroma of romance that is unmistakably...
Windbreaker.
Squeeze the atomizer. And feel the scent of luxury cover you with its magic. And walk through a crowded cafe on a cloud of mystery.
What is that smell?
Somebody light a match.
Windbreaker.
Windbreaker. Experience the passion.
Windbreaker Perfume and Toilet Water, a division of Old El Paso Frozen Mexican Food.
Forecast calls for sunny skies. We may reach 80 degrees Saturday along the... Oh, wait a second. That's the Los Angeles forecast. You have to check on your own somewhere else.
Hurt me, why don't you?
Yeah. Here we go. Oh, no. Not the phone. Not now.
Don't answer the phone.
But it might be important. Hello?
Hey, Camp. What's up?
Not much, Harry.
What are you guys doing?
Not much anymore.
Leave me alone, phone!
Men, has this ever happened to you? A meaningless phone call interrupting your lovemaking session? Well, when you're hard, you'll be hard to reach with Mickey Moose International's Leave Me Alone While I Bone Phone. Yes, it's the Leave Me Alone While I Bone Phone. A simple electronic hookup. Just attach the handy extension cord directly from your phone outlet to your penis. When you've got an erection, it sends your calls in another direction. When you're stiff, you'll get done in a jiff with no interruptions. No more losing that boner with ringing from your phoner. The Leave Me Alone While I Bone Phone, only from Mickey Moose International.
And it rhymes! Woo! 7:21 in the morning, Zoo. Let's check the Go Patrol. Here's Rennell.
There's a stall northbound 101
sure
at Vermont.
It's Rennell.
Traffic again in 10 minutes on 106. KMEL!
It's now! It's now! 12!
7! 22!
Like hell!
Ron fell!
Oh, what the
We're
hell?
We're gonna see what.
That's it. Let's take your sports.
Woo! Sports! Sports!
Hey, the Warriors won last night. 106-104. Warriors over the Knicks. Bang! We'll talk about it later.
Oh, yes. Look for 70s and maybe even 80 or so around the bay today. No rain in sight right now in the city. It's 50 degrees.
Hi, Joe Garagiola here.
Written all over your face.
7:29, John London and your Friday morning zoo. Clearing skies. It looks like smog out there, doesn't it?
Better get used to that, boys.
Woo!
Now, remember we had LeVar come in? I guess it was a couple months ago.
At Hot Rod Cafe.
Yeah, Hosh had brought him in, had seen him perform live in a lobby at the St. Francis Hotel during the big convention weekend, the Glavin Report convention.
Gavinger.
And Hosh said, hey, this guy's something special, got him signed that night to Epic Records. Mm-hmm. They've been in the studio. Hosh has been helping out. Remember, he did live version of the Vanilla Melt?
Yeah.
It is now out. This guy's great. This guy is absolutely great. Let's take a listen to LeVar and Vanilla Melt.
You ought to be ashamed of yourself. Yeah!
Wanna battle anytime, anywhere. So all I'm saying is, yeah, I wanna battle tomorrow at his house. I got something for Vanilla Ice on the distemper slice. See, precisely done nice, just the way it should be done. He'll probably up and run when he sees the movement of my tongue. If he swings, daddy's hung, round one. What you gonna do round two if I'm sprung? Nothing, because I'm not bluffing. Just running with my lyrical huffing and puffing. Word to your mother absurd. Guitar for smack, then Beretta's fur. But LeVar's been dealt 9 years under my belt. And I'm coming up, cooking the Vanilla Melt.
I'm gonna get you, baby. I'm gonna get you, yeah. Ooh.
Yes, that's my answer. I got the rap, perhaps you should have been my dancer. But no, so, you had your time on the show. Another fly by night, I'm a crow. Your rag top's down, that's cool, bro. But yo, you got a flat top, your hair can't blow. Whoa, better get your lyrics straight if we're dueling. Now who you fooling? Not me, you fake, I see. You dripping, slipping. LeVar's giving you a whipping. Had you run rhyme, but now I'm gonna spoil it. I think of you and your crew when I'm on the toilet. Crap, fills your rap, you're a blooper. They should follow you around with a pooper scooper. To pick up what you're leaving behind, you can't rhyme. And I fell like making the Vanilla Melt.
I'm gonna get you, baby. I'm gonna get you, yeah.
Ooh.
I'm gonna get you, baby.
vanilla melt with cheese, and let me get some fries, please. Oh, let me get a Coke to wash down that joke.
Word. Third verse. It gets worse. Watch it bubble burst. I go nuts over the cuts in it. Hurts. Just under degree. He might D.I.E. Yo, B, don't step to me. You can't hang with my slang of a mic or bang. Cause it's the way I let my lyrics flow to make the crowd go dang. Besides that, it's just a face, man. You don't wanna bow me. I'll play you like Pac-Man. Damn. Hard on a level you don't know. So until you grow up, don't even show up. Cause I'll sweat and rip your works like a beast. Then you and your weak lyrics left in peace. See, I know what the scheme's about, yeah. So I put the sucker's head out. A lucky man, if you know what I mean. I mean, where would it be without Bowie and Queen? McDonald's, still serving fries and telling lies in Texas or Miami, Compton, wherever he's from. Lamar's been dealt, the vanilla melt.
I'm gonna get you, baby.
You said you'd battle, so I'ma take you up on your offer and make the soft look soft. Word to your grandmother's name.
That was good.
Kiss my white butt.
Hey, Vanilla. Come on.
As nasty as they'll let us be. The Two Live Zoo on 106 KMEL.
No, I don't think just leave that one behind. Thank you.
This is nice.
It is nice, isn't it?
Yeah.
John London's big record party starts. What do we think, about 8:30 now?
I think so, yeah.
Well, we'll do it right after the pick to click, coming up with Hosh. 106.1 KMEL at 7:44. John London, the Zoo Crew, our last show.
Oh, yeah.
This edition, the new edition, the new Jack Zoo. Word. Is Monday morning with Rennell. And hi. Word. Good morning. What can I do for you?
I don't know whether it's desperation or I'm hallucinating, but I just feel like this is a major April Fool's joke. Can I say that?
Yeah, you can. Is that what you really think?
Well, I don't want to get everybody else in the Bay Area's hopes up, but God, I can't wait till Monday and hear your voice again, and you just laugh at all of us for being such pinheads.
Mm. What a beautiful April Fool's joke.
It would be a classic.
It would be one of the, greatest radio. Classic. That would be fabulous.
I mean, you even have the media in on this, you know? You got, what's his name, Ben Fawn, whatever, Ben Fondue?
Yeah.
Rimshot him.
That deserves a one. Hang on.
But I want
guy goes into a doctor.
No. All right.
But if it is, I'll be the happiest guy here Monday morning.
Well, I'll just tell you this, sir. The very nice lady that I spoke to at the phone company when I called to have my phone turned off said, I thought it was a joke until you're canceling your phone, aren't you? You wouldn't be doing that if it weren't a joke. So you'll see Monday morning.
Mm. Well, you know, maybe you canceled your phone because you've got the station so worried you're moving like to Blackhawk or something because of the pay increase.
Oh, you got it all figured out, huh? All right.
I'll let my twisted mind believe what I want to believe.
There you go. The truth. We'll be seen Monday.
If you're not there, good luck.
Thanks very much.
So long.
Bye-bye. 7:46 in the morning, Zoo. I won't be here Monday.
No, won't.
I won't be here, but Rennell will be here.
You come down and look at the tears in my eyes, you will know this is not an April Fool's joke, ladies and gentlemen. I promise you.
That's just alcohol sweat. Let's be honest now. That's not tears. I know salt when I see it. Let's go back a little ways. Maybe you perhaps remember this little ditty from the Zoo past.
You can touch this. You can touch this. You can touch this. You can touch this.
My.
You can touch this.
Every time you see me, my zipper is on duty. I'm out with some cutie, and I gotta touch your booty. Now, why would I ever stop doing this? I've flown around the world, from Cleveland to the Bay. It's zipper go my zipper. That's right, you guys can kiss my A.
You can touch this. You can touch this. You can touch this.
Break it down. Zipper time. Hater wave. It's bodacious. You will say, oh my gracious. When you get my love and tactics, I got gels and prophylactics. Here's a thing you cannot dodge. Come to the Sixpence Motor Lodge. It may be grand. A bit too much. You can touch this. You can touch
touch this.
Oh, 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 oh.
Touch this.
Oh, I think so. Don't be shy.
You can touch this.
There's plenty for everybody.
Oh, oh, I can touch this.
Oh, I think we got the Grand Teton in effect. Every day.
Still the world's greatest song. There's no doubt about that.
Give me just 1 second. Hang on, if I do one quick
thing. What city, please?
Yes, guy goes into a doctor's office and says, Doc, why don't you take a look at my penis? Doc says, well, join the table, pull your pants down. So he does that. Doc looks, studies it for a while, says, I don't get it. What seems to be the problem? Guy says, nothing. Why don't you take a look at my penis? Oakland, please. The Jones residence.
Yeah! 7:48 in the morning. Let's check the Go Patrol.
Oh my God.
Here's Rennell.
Is this news? Is this the 50?
No, this is 35.
Oh, okay.
This is 35.
Okay. Well, we have a light commute this morning. Bay Bridge Toll Plaza in good shape. A couple of earlier stalls reported westbound 92.
Oh, this is the news,
San Mateo Bridge. Is it the 50?
I think, you know.
Let's just do it.
It is the 50.
It is the 50.
Okay.
We're early.
In that case, this Go Patrol is brought to you by Fry's Food Stores.
Hey, all right. It's now 7:48. I hope I've got the spots. This news being brought to you by, oh, here it is, Prati Nissan Suzuki. I got a special way to do the news this morning. Let me just say one thing. This is going to be a foreshadowing of what's going to be coming. Let me just say this. A couple of our boys who served in the Gulf, they weren't really such heroes. They were crying wolf, doing it for Hussein, but it was all in vain. They pulled some sabotage on the USS Ranger, tried to convince their buddies to kidnap the skipper. Now they're in the stockade, as tight as a zipper.
Ah!
If you're looking for hot, I'll show you the spot. The fire came twice. Now it's as cold as ice on the roof of our embassy, where we make Russian policy. They still don't know why there was a blaze. They're out looking at it back through the haze. When we come back, the scandal is national. We'll tell you why the cops are irrational.
You, here's the story. The guys at 7 price plus tax license and dock fee.
7:50. The scandal is national. Cops are irrational. So now from the Barrows to Harlem comes the sensational Reverend Al Sharpton to call for the ouster of Chief Daryl Gates, the man for whom Sharpie be packing some hate. Peace.
You every day.
Check your sports. Here's Dennis.
NBA action last night. Warriors beat the Knicks 106-104. Warriors backup center, 7-foot Paul Molesky, trips a fast-breaking Pat Ewing, stops him at the one-yard line. No score. Warriors stop the slide. Next up, Warriors in Motown. Tonight, they take on the Pistons. 4 o'clock tip-off for that one. That's Zeus Sports. I'm Dennis Cruz. Why do you leave Harper on the line?
Lower 70s today, mid-70s tomorrow, sunny and warm through the weekend. Right now in the city, it's 48 degrees.
It's getting warm in here, I know that.
Hello.
7:53, let's do it. My final suck wall at 478-KMEL. We're going to take about 20 calls this morning. An extended suck wall for you. 47. If you don't know the number, don't. Don't even. Start with me now.
Here we go. I hope there's enough paint left for the... Yeah.
Yeah, we got some. Good morning. You're on the suck wall. Who do you want to put up there? Good morning.
Good morning.
Good morning.
How do you do?
Good, thanks.
Okay, John.
Yes, sir.
Just one quick question.
Yeah.
What is a suck wall? I am new at this.
Took this long. What's your name?
My name is Biden.
Martin?
Byron?
Yes. I'll tell you, I'm going to do it for you. I'm just going to put you right up there on the suck wall, Byron. All right. Thanks very much. We're still educating them. We're still educating
Six
them.
Years.
Good morning.
Hello?
Hi, who do you want to put on the suck wall?
I'd like to put you guys up for leaving us.
Oh, now, come on. Don't do this. Give me a break. Can't I have a career?
Yes, you can, but you have to have it here because we love you all.
Oh, that is so nice. What is your name?
Debbie,
thank you so much.
Sure.
But, you know, listen to the new Jack Sue.
I will.
Monday morning.
And when I go down to L.A., what radio station you guys going to be on?
It's The Beat.
Okay.
92.3. And, you know, down there we celebrate life, too. As a matter of fact, Rennell, you've got to give out the request line number our first day, April 8th, all right? We want to jam The Beat request lines with Zoo listeners, all right? I'm going to need that support.
I'm
going to
need some support, too, John.
Well, they're going to be calling you going, you're sounding great, Rennell. You're doing great.
No, they'll be calling you. We miss you, John. Come back.
No, they'll be saying, you're great, and you'll be going, no, I ain't. You know, boom. Good morning, KMEL.
I'd like to put my French school...
Who, what?
My French school.
Your French school.
All right.
What are they teaching you there at French school?
I don't know, but they're not fair. They make me copy out of the encyclopedia just if I don't do my homework.
Oh, French ain't what it used to be, I can tell you that.
And they make me watch.
Yeah, whatever. Oh, hi, good morning.
Good morning.
Hi, who do you want to put on the suck wall?
AC Transit.
AC Transit.
I mean, because my car broke down. I had to take the bus for a couple of days. They wait until you put the dollar bill in the machine, and they take off. You don't have a seat. You fall into the guy next to you. The guy's drooling on you. They wait till you put the money in. They're quiet then. As soon as you take off, boom,
boom,
they're gone.
Vroom, vroom, at about 80 miles an hour, right?
And never fails, every of them. It's like a thing they teach you in school.
We got them up there. Thanks a lot. Mm-hmm. It's also a pet peeve. It's suckwall and pet peeve.
There you go.
South Bay, who do you want to put up there?
Conde College.
And why do you want to put them up there?
Because I attended one orientation class, and they sent me a bill for $2,047.
Hey, education is expensive. That was some orientation class.
They suck.
They were orientating themselves towards your wallets.
Thank you. Yeah. Yes, they were.
Thanks a lot. We got them up there. Hi, who do you want to put on the suck wall?
Art Harlan.
And how do you, why do you want to put a little Art up there?
Because he's a fat slob and a lousy supervisor.
All right.
He sucks.
That's right.
Good morning. Who do you want to put up there?
My brother, Cesar Almanza.
Your brother?
Yeah.
All right.
Oh, God. Hey.
Why?
Yeah. Why?
Because he loves you guys. And, you know, I mean, that guy's a loyal listener. I mean, you're just a suck kid. I mean, you know, there's nothing else I can say. And I'm going to miss you guys, by the way. My brother's going to miss you. He wants me to tell you that. He loves you guys. He woke up forever. For 5 years, he was telling me. So, you know, what else can I say? I wish you the best.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Okay.
Bye-bye. Good morning. Who do you want to put on the suck wall?
Jack, go to hell! Go to hell, die!
Okay?
Burn forever in hell!
Damn it.
Good morning. Who do you want to put on the suck wall?
Tape Tech in Redwood City.
And why do you want to put them up there?
Because they don't know how to treat their employees.
Oh, yeah? How do they treat their employees, sir?
They just don't give them no respect.
That sounds like they do know how to treat their employees. You still like the way they're treating you. There's a difference there, sir. We got them up there.
All right, thanks.
Thank you very much. One more. We'll go to the South Bay. Hi, who do you want to put on the suck wall?
Yeah, my principal.
Yo, what's his name? Give a shout out to him.
I don't think so.
What's his name?
It's Mr. McLean.
Oh,
a nun.
Hey.
No, don't.
My last suck wall is a nun?
No. This keep is going.
Yeah,
that's
wrong. I can't end with that. No. Not on Good Friday. No. Whoa, that combination is ugly. Good morning.
Yeah, I want to put the people who thought Ronnie Lott was too old to play anymore.
That's the suck wall I want to end on. Absolutely. What are the 49ers thinking about, for crying out loud? The inspirational team leader?
Yeah.
The man who gives 120%, who rallies the troops behind him? They're idiots. Thanks very much. Appreciate it. Take care. You know, you still can't participate.
How?
Well, you just walk up to your boss. Yep. Yeah. Oh, watch him fall out there. That's if your boss is the sister. Okay, the nun or something. If not, then you just gotta get a high chair. Gotta get a high chair. Stand up there on it. Turn around. Give him one of those, and then you say,
"You suck.
Take this job and shove it. I ain't working here no more."
Yes. Ugliest woman in the world out here. I can't believe it. Oh, now come on. He sucks.
Yeah, I will. Yeah.
Oh,
yeah.
God.
That's right.
Oh, God.
I got the FCC in the line.
What? Oh, man.
Good morning.
Hello.
Yes.
Yeah, this is Jack Koch. It's spelled K-O-C-H, Koch, but it's Koch. Head Commissioner FCC. Is this Mr. John London?
Yes, it is.
If you don't know what that is, mister, it's the Federal Communication Commission monitoring all the crap that seeps throughout the airwaves, all right?
I'm fully aware of that, sir, yes.
All right, let me make one thing clear. That brings me to the reason I called, Mr. London. I've received some complaints. Your content has been trashy since day one, and don't think this move to L.A. is going to get me off your ass, okay, mister? I'll be watching you like a freak in a sideshow. So much as one derogatory piece of filthy slime comes out of your mouth, I'll be up your butt with a microscope slapping fines on you so quick you'll think hawking prices at Kmart is the sweetest gig you ever had. And,
yes, sir.
As for that filthy little mother scratcher cigar man, his days are number two. Mr. London, learn to look over your shoulder when you walk, or learn to walk again, mister. In closing, just let me say, good luck on your future endeavors and keep it clean, sir.
Thank you. On the phone line from the Glavin Report, ladies and gentlemen, once again.
Glavin, John.
Dave Sholin. What's up, Dave?
Hey, the Glavin, why get it right on the last day?
How you doing this morning?
I'm doing great. You guys are, I tell you, very sad. You sound very sad.
Do we?
Yeah. We're down.
Down in the dumps, Dave.
All I got to say is, listen, L.A. is a suck wall.
Come on now.
Don't forget it.
Well, I will. This will always be home to me. We'll be back visiting many, many times.
And remember, we want to see you here. But listen, the Glavin is a national publication, guys.
Gavin,
I got you. I remember.
Oh, is it a Gavin?
The Gavin.
Oh.
I know. We get it down in Los Angeles.
Well, Ron Fell is, he brought a man to tears. The guy's, I don't know if he's tears of joy or laughter or sadness, but he's sad to see you go. We all are sad to see you go. And I know you're going to come back and join us for next year's convention.
Oh, you know that. Absolutely. Uh-huh. Absolutely.
Make those awards up.
Get some new hookers, though. Dave, the old hookers at your convention really are getting a little tiresome, okay?
Let me make a note on that.
All right.
Hookers, okay? We've got that down. I'll pass that along to our publisher.
Thanks, Dave.
Okay, listen, have a great time. I've already given advice to the guys down there in L.A. I said, get off the air. Just leave.
There you go.
Why even stick around?
Thanks, Dave. I appreciate it. Thank you. I'll be talking to you soon.
Okay.
Good guy. Dave Sholin.
Good
guy. Gavin. 8:24 in the morning. Now, listen, Dennis, I understand you've put together a little something special for us this morning.
Yeah, it's not that special, but yeah.
Well, you know, but it's little. It's from you. We knew it couldn't be. But let's run it by us anyway.
It's a little something.
Oh, yeah.
It's just some of our favorite music here.
Long intro.
Big long intro.
Jin Dan.
Start spreading the news. We're finished here today. We're making the ride down Interstate 5 to Los Angeles. I won't need no shoes.
Don't need no shoes.
Cause no one walks in L.A.
No walking.
I see my festiva loaded with babes down in Los Angeles. Oh, I wanna hang out in a town where you cannot breathe. To hang with all of those coke snorting Hollywood sleaze. My Bay Area blues aren't just going away.
They're going away.
But there's some bucks to be made down in L.A. Well, it should be breeze to stomp that dick. Rick Dees down in SoCal, Los Angeles. Wake up,
yes, sir,
in a sweat in that L.A. heat. 3-hour commute into work. Ha. No morning show will compete with FM 92.3, also known as the Beat. We're gonna make a new stand. Big Dog and Brian and I gonna try our hand. Oh, down in the Southland. And if we don't make it there, hey, there's real cheap airfare back to the Bay from the 55 Chief Gates in Los Angeles.
Ah! Right here.
All right. Stand up.
8:28 on the morning zoo.
Need a lozenge? I hurt just listening to it.
We all hurt listening to him. 8:28, let's check that Go Patrol. Here's Rennell.
Accident in the South Bay northbound.
106.1 KMEL. Teddy Pendergrass.
Yeah.
I
I don't know how it happened, but he ended up with my vocal cords.
Uh-huh.
Man, the man sings so beautifully.
Yes, he does.
8:48 on the Morning Zoo. It's another last, ladies and gentlemen. My last. Pick the click. Our music director, Hosh Gorelli. Good morning, Hosh. How are you?
Good morning, John. What a show, man. What a show. I'm dying.
Yeah, I have a feeling that's what Paulette's going. What a show. What a son of a bitch show. What are they thinking about? Now, you said you had something special for us.
And we delivered.
For you.
For what you, John. Absolutely. Just for you.
Just for me.
And I know we're going to piss off a lot of radio stations again. But that's what we do best.
Yeah, we've been doing that for years. Why stop now?
Ladies and gentlemen, the world premiere of the brand new Luther Vandross song, Power of Love.
Yes!
A world premiere exclusive on KMEL.
When I say goodbye.
What were you applicants at that time? Hey, that's, can you believe it? It's time. We got to go. And where do I begin to thank all of the people here at KMEL? You know? We got to thank. Is Paulette in town?
No.
And I'm not gonna thank her. Okay. Thank all the stiff necks at Century Broadcasting there in Chicago. Of course. No. And everybody here at Century's been beautiful to me. Paulette has been great. Keith, again, thank you for everything over the 6 years that we've been together. Hosh, you've been great. The Wiz, we're gonna miss you. All the people here. Michael Erickson, I'll miss you. I'm gonna run the front office, ladies. Danny, Mary. Franklin, you big lug, I'm going to kick your ass at the pier in a moment. I am. I swear to God, I'll come right over to the stinking console if I have to. I want to thank everybody who's been so supportive of this show for all of the years. Rennell, especially, you are fabulous. You're going to do well. You're going to you're going to look back and go, I can't believe we had such crummy, crappy ratings when John was here.
No, I love you very much, and thank you for this opportunity, and you've just, I can't even express to you how much you've taught for me and done for me.
Thank you, Rennell. I appreciate that very much.
Good luck, and I'm really going to miss you.
No, well, you'll only miss me for a little while, because we'll be in touch, always. Thanks so much for everybody. Let's get some happy trail singers on here before I start to cry, will you, for crying out loud? I'm a veteran! I don't cry. Hi, you want to sing Happy Trails with us?
Yeah, sure.
All right, what are your names?
I'm Brian from Sunnyvale, big radio fanatic.
All right, Brian. Hey, were you in our commercial? Slammin'.
Hey, John.
Yeah.
Will you do one thing for me before you leave?
What's that?
Will you please play that Bite Me drop with the thunder and the glare, please? Oh.